Hi guys, it's Crystal with Design Bundles. Today I'm going to show you guys how you guys can take your files straight from Design Bundles straight to your print manager from Sawgrass. Did you know that you can send those straight to your print manager without using Sawgrass Creative Studio? And I'm going to show you guys how you guys can size it and all of those things, add multiple to one sheet. So let's say, for example, I just downloaded this PNG from Design Bundles and I'm ready to print it out. All I'm simply going to do is I'm going to drag and drop it into this Sawgrass Smart Folder. Now, if you did not realize or notice that when you purchased your Sawgrass printer, it came with a folder that popped up on your computer that says Sawgrass Smart Folder. What is this? This is a smart folder, as you will, that is designed out to where if you drop this in there, this screen right here will automatically pop up. So every time you drop a file in there, it's just going to pop up right here. So what you're going to be able to do is add as many of these smart folders as you want to. Now, say for example, I just want one and I just drag and drop and I'll change all of that right here. Or I could create as many as I want to, and I can have one that's for my Caesar HTV. I could have one that's for my ceramic mugs. I could have one that's specifically for my phone cases. I also even have one, since I have a chromoblast set of inks for one of my printers, I even have a cotton setting. So let's say, for example, you're just going to be using that Sawgrass Smart Folder, and I've dragged and dropped this in here, and this screen has popped up. You're going to have those options to change it to polyester, to metal, whatever you're going to want to your substrate is. You can change your print quality. You can change whatever paper you're using. Let's say, for example, I want to change it from the bypass tray to tray one. You can change it whether it's going to mirror and all those kind of things. You can move on to layout just like you normally would, and you can choose all of this kind of stuff. I can change it that I want it to be on 11 by 17 piece of paper, all of that kind of fun stuff. I can also come over to jobs and I can change the width and height and stuff here. So say for example that I'm actually going to be making this around 4 inches. So I'm going to come up here for my width and it's actually going to be 4 inches. So what it's going to do is it's going to change that height for me. So it's going to adjust everything that needs to be changed, just like so. I can also say, okay, I want 2 copies, and it's going to add another one. Now, say for example, I want to add another image to this page. All I'm going to do is I'm going to grab my next PNG. I'm going to drop it into that smart folder. And you're going to notice this is going to pop up. Now, it's on a separate sheet because it hasn't been sized yet. So I'm also wanting this to be at 4 inches. So I'm going to change the width to 4 inches, and it's going to add to this sheet of paper. Same thing. Maybe I want 2 copies of that one. I can do the same thing. So you can do all of this stuff right here in Sawgrass Print Manager, and I don't even have to go over to the Sawgrass Creative Studio. Now, say for example, I want to gap these out. I can come back to layout and add a little bit of spacing here, so that way I can perfectly cut in between these. So you can do that as well. If I want to continue to add more and more, and I'm going to do it on 11 by 17 sheet of paper, I can do so here. And then I can come back to jobs and I can continue to add more. So say for example, I want to add a 3rd copy. I'm going to click on another one. Or maybe I decided I don't want that one. I can actually come to the minus and I can minus that back off. Just like that. And I can continue to go on. So I could grab my next PNG, drop it in that smart folder, and once again, it's going to pop up. So I'm going to change that size here and I'm going to say I want it to be the 4 inches, just like everything else. And it's going to add it in just like so. So on and so forth. But maybe I don't. Maybe I'm actually going to be having this one be 6 inches. So as you guys can see, you can add your download straight to your computer, drop it into that folder, and it's going to pop up. And you can size all of those things right here. So right up here at the top, you should have your print manager. If it's already open, you're going to click on it here. And you're going to notice the Smart Folder Manager. Now, if you are on Windows, usually those are down here on your computer around the right side. You're going to want to right click and you'll see the same thing where it says Smart Folder Manager. So from here, you're going to click here, and this is where all of these folders are. Now, like I said, if you're just getting started, you should only have one that says Sawgrass Smart Folder. So if you want to add multiple, you're going to hit your plus here. And if you want to delete one, you're going to hit your minus. So whichever one is lit up in gray. So say, for example, I want to get rid of phone cases. I'm going to hit the minus. It's going to delete it just like so. But then you still need to come to your computer and delete it here. All right, so I'm going to add one. I'm going to hit the plus sign. And then we are going to go to desktop. and we are going to go to new folder. So at this point, you want to name it. So say, for example, this is all the settings for my phone cases. And I'm going to hit create. Next up, you're going to hit open. And now you're ready to set the settings. So you want to make sure it's highlighted. You can see it's gray here, phone cases. You're going to be able to choose your printer. So if you have multiple printers, you're going to choose that here. And then your materials, same thing. So I want to make sure all of these are correct for the phone cases. And every single time I drop something in there, these same settings are going to pop up. So let's go ahead and say our substrate is metal. Print quality, all of those are going to stay the same. Let's say that I use the TruePix Classic, tray one. I'm going to come to my color and make sure it's set to vivid. And then I can come to my layout. I'm going to make sure it's, I'm going to do the print manager performs my layout for me. So that way, if I need to have it, you know, size down or change anything that it needs to do. And then I'm going to go ahead and choose page size. What do I normally print these on? Maybe I print these on my mug size paper. So I'm going to put them on mug standard. So I would choose that here. If not, if I'm just using the 8.5 by 11, I could leave it there as well. So you want to make sure that you do come to Smart Folder here. This is very, very important. And you want to make sure that all of these files here are selected. If you ever drop something into your folder and it does not pop up, then you need to check right here on the Smart Folder because these obviously have not been checkmarked to pop up. So this means it's going to accept all of these files here. So make sure you go ahead and check all of those. Your next option here, if you have a business and you want this just to automatically print to the printer, you know that this size right here is correct. You can drop it in there and it's automatically going to skip this step and just send it straight to your printer. You can definitely do that. Now, I just recommend I leave mine off. That way I do have the option to come in and change or add multiple to one sheet. So definitely feel free to do that however you would like. Now, once you have all your settings, you're just going to simply hit save and you're good to go. So now you can see I've got that folder here. I try to keep these all bunched together. All right, so let's go ahead and drop this one into our phone cases. We are going to duplicate this and drop it right on inside, and it's going to pop up just like this. So we've got all of our settings going on. If you notice your design doesn't pop up, you just need to simply come over here to layout and change that to either preserve layout and it'll pop up, or you need to change that page size and then go from there. So say, for example, I change it to 11 by 17, that's gonna pop up. Or I keep it back on that 8.5 by 11, but I change it to preserve. So just feel free to mess around with that as you need to. And then once again, you would go to jobs and you would change those settings here. Now, if you ever notice that if I go to change my settings here and I hit width and it's trying to change my width here to the same, see how it's doing that? And it's going to distort it. Then you need to go back over here to layout and change it to print manager performs the layout. Then you're going to notice that it's going to do it correctly. So if you ever have those issues, just definitely change that there. So I hope you guys enjoyed this. I hope you guys found it helpful. If you did, please hit the like button down below and subscribe. And I'll see you guys on the next one.